Start solving exercise 3.2. The first question in that is, write the answer of each of the following questions. What is the name of the horizontal and the vertical lines drawn to determine the position of any point in the Cartesian plane? So, the name of the horizontal line is the x-axis. The name of the vertical line is the y-axis. So the answer is x-axis and y-axis. Now second question in that, what is the name of each part of the plane formed by these two lines? So each part of the plane is this part, this part, this part and this part. The name of the each part of the plane is called quadrants. The answer is quadrant. This is first quadrant, this is second quadrant, this is third quadrant, this is fourth quadrant. Now third question in that, write the name of the point where these two lines intersect. So these two lines, that is x-axis and y-axis, they intersect at a point, and this point is called, as I have told you earlier, this point is called origin. Okay, this point is called the origin. The point of intersection of x and y axis is called the origin. Then the second main question is, see figure and write the following, the coordinates of B. So the B is here. First see the x coordinates on x axis. First see the coordinates on x axis here. B on x axis the coordinates are -5 and on y axis the coordinates are 2. So the coordinates of B, we can write it as -5, 2. Always write the x coordinate first. Okay, so the coordinates are -5, 2. First write the x coordinate, then write the y coordinate. Then they have asked the coordinates of C. C is a point here. See what are the coordinates on x-axis. First see the coordinates on x-axis, then see the coordinates on y-axis. X coordinate is 5, y coordinate is -5. So first write the x coordinate, that is 5, then you write the y coordinate, that is -5. X coordinate of C is 5, y coordinate of C is -5. So the coordinates of C are 5, -5. Now the third question is, the point identified by the coordinates -3, -5. Now we will say, where is -3, -5? Okay, so this point you can see, that is E point. The x coordinate is -3, the y coordinate is -5. So the answer is, the point identified by -3, -5 is E. The answer is, the point identified by -3, -5 is E. Okay, so E is the point which is identified by the coordinates -3, -5. So I have written it here. Okay, then the fourth question in that is, the point identified by the coordinates 2, 4. The question is, identify the point, okay, which has the coordinates 2, 4. We'll see 2, 4, which point has. We will see now which point is identified by the coordinates 2, -4. Let us see, 2 comes here and -4 comes here. So the point identified by 2, -4 is G. Okay, So the point identified by the coordinates 2 comma minus 4 is what? G. So I have written the answer here. Now the fifth question is the abscissa of the point D. Abscissa means the x coordinate. Let us see the x coordinate of point D. See, D is the point here. The x coordinate of this is 6. Okay, the actual coordinates are 6, 2. So the abscissa means the x coordinate. The x coordinate of D is 6. So the abscissa of D is 6, as I told you. The x coordinate of D is what? 6, you can see here. Okay. Now the sixth question in that is the ordinate of the point H. Ordinate means the y coordinate. Let us see the y coordinate or ordinate of point H. So H is here, H is the point here. Ordinate of H means what? The y coordinate. On the y axis you have to see. So the ordinate of H is what? Minus 3. So write down that answer. The ordinate of H is minus. The next question is the coordinates of the point L. So L is the point here on the y axis. On the y axis you can see the x coordinate is 0 and y coordinate is 5. So the answer is 0, 5. The coordinates of L are 0, 5. So the next question is the coordinates of M. So M is the point here. Okay, the coordinates of point M. M coordinates on the x axis it is minus 3. And on the y axis you can say it is 0 only. So the coordinates of the point M are minus 3, 0. Okay, so M is a point on the x axis. So its coordinates are minus 3, 0. So always remember, always remember that the coordinates of a point on the x axis will be, on the x axis, the y coordinate will be 0. Just like here you can see for M. On the x axis, for a point on the x axis, y coordinate is 0. And for a point on the y axis, the x coordinate is 0. Always remember that. This is how you can, what you can say, plot the points on the Cartesian plane. Okay. Take down these notes. We'll meet in the next class.